Alright, welcome back to Everything Mathematics. And today we're going to finish up basically what we started yesterday. So yesterday we learned how to complete the square, and we did it with simple equations. That is when a is equal to 1. Today we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to show you how to do it when a is not equal to 1. But remember, if you saw yesterday's video and you learned anything from it, today's procedure should be very easy because we're doing the same thing. But we just have to bear one thing in mind that we add into it. That's what we're going to do today. So this is our objective for today. Let's complete this square when a is not equal to 1. And here is the process, just like yesterday. Notice though, however, there's only one additional step. Step 2 wasn't there yesterday because remember, we did not have an a. But now that step 2 is here, now that there is an a, or now that a is not equal to 1, we're going to factor out a within the brackets. So remember, the first thing we were supposed to do is pair the x terms, which we did yesterday. But then after we paired the x term, we went straight to, oh, look at that, that's step 2 twice. So it's supposed to be step 2. Poor thing. This here, shucks, I skipped it. Anyway, I ain't have time to go back. But yes, in essence, we're doing the same thing, but you have to factor out a. So let's do that. So firstly, we pair x. Good? We pair the x's. Yesterday, there was no value here. But now there is. Look at a 4. So we factor out the 4. That's where we start. So we factor out the 4. And we end up with x squared. 8 divided by, or 4 could go into 8, or if I want to look at it. 2x times plus 7. Notice though, whatever the coefficient of x squared is, that is what we factor out. We don't care about the rest. We don't care whether the others, it's a factor of the number or not. The only thing we care about is the coefficient of x squared. We want to make that 1. And once we do that, then we could go and find half of b, which was the second step 2 I was going to correct before I move this slide. But how this thing set up, once I move forward, I cannot go back. But yes, step 3 now is supposed to be you find half of b. And from here, we're playing the same game from yesterday. Right? So here now we have a scenario like this, 4, big bracket, x squared minus 2x plus negative 1 all squared. Yes, negative 1 is half of b. Look at it, b as it is right now is negative 2. So half of b will be negative 1 and we square it. And on the outside now we have plus 7, and this is where something gets interesting. Yesterday, we added half of b on the inside and we subtracted outside. But today now, we're not just only subtracting half of b, we are also subtracting this 4. Because this is something that affected the equation on the inside of the bracket, but it didn't do anything on the outside. And as you should know by now, when it comes to rules to equation, whatever you do to affect an equation, you have to do it over to keep it balanced. So what we added inside here, we have to take away, and we're taking away the 4 inclusive of half of b squared. That's what we're taking away on the other side. So on the inside now, we will have 4 into x minus 1 all squared. Remember, I said it yesterday over and over. To find out what you have here, all you need to do is remember what was half of b. Whatever half of b was is what will end up inside here at all times. And on the outside, we have a little equation to solve here. Let me just write it over here. So we have 7. Let me not confuse you. Let me draw my line this. Good. So we have 7 minus 4. And this minus 1 all squared here, what? It will just end up being minus. It will just end up being 1. Because we have, technically, we'll have minus 1 times minus 1. And that is just positive 1. It will be positive 1. And positive 1 times 4, you know, is just 4. So this whole thing outside here will just work out to be plus 3. And guess what? That's the answer there. We're done. If it's equal to 0, then we could just go ahead and solve for x. But that's it there. That's what we want. And this is closer to the replica of the standard form. So this will be a into x plus h all squared plus k. So we could say our k is 3, our h is negative 1, and our a is 4. And sometimes they ask you that for CXE. They could ask you, find a, h, and k. And that's all we did here. By completing this square, we found a, h, and k. And be mindful of the notation too. I forgot to say that yesterday. When it comes to completing this square, they will give you options. Generally though, when they tell you to factorize, they don't expect you to complete this square. I'm telling you that generally. But if you want, you could. If possible, you could. However, when it comes to factorizing, they will either tell you, complete this square of the equation 4x squared minus 8x plus 7. They will tell you that. Or they will tell you, write 4x squared minus 8x plus 7 in the form, that's the notation you need to be aware, in the form of a into x plus h r squared plus k. Either or. So if they do this, technically they're asking you to do the same thing, complete this square. So they will either tell you write it in this form, or they will tell you straight out, plain out, complete this square. So it's your call, it's your choice. Or not your call, your choice. But it's you to know so that you could follow suit. Good? I think we have another example. Yeah, let's do another example. So here we have another equation. And again, follow the procedure. First thing, I pair my x terms. Secondly, because a is not equal to 1, I factor that out. So I just want to factor out the 3. I don't care about if that 3 could go into any other number. In this case, it could, luckily. But you just want the x squared to be 1. So to do that, we factor out 3. So that will leave us with x squared minus 4x plus 5. So again, notice this 3 only affected the inside function. So that 3 will have to be subtracted outside later down the line, as we saw in the previous question. And from here, we go back to what we know best. So we have 3 on the outside still. And inside now we have x squared minus 4x plus half of b. So that will be minus 2 all squared. And we close inside. And on the outside now we had plus 5 minus the 3 that we factor out on the inside, along with the minus 2 squared, which was half of b. And from here we simplify, so we ended up with 3 into x minus 2 all squared. And on the outside here, let's see, we will end up with 5. Let me write it out over here. Let me take a different color. So we have 5 minus 3 into minus 2 all squared, which is the same thing as 5 minus 3 into 4, which is the same as 5 minus 12. And 5 minus 12, that should give us negative 7. Oh, I forgot to change the color. That should give us negative 7. And this should be our answer here. So that's two examples. Let's see if you could do some on your own now. So here we have again three examples. Let's see, one of them will end up with a fraction, or two will end up with a fraction, and the first one will work out nicely with whole numbers. So of course, here is where you could pause the video. And here I said factorize the following by completing the square. So I specifically ask you to complete the square. Good. Let's move on. Number one. I trust you took time to do it and you're just waiting to see what I do. So you pair your x terms, you factor all that 5 because you don't want x squared to have something. So you have 5 outside, inside, you have x squared plus 2x minus 2. Then you find half of b. So that is 5 into x squared. Let me put a square bracket. 5 into x squared plus 2x minus. Plus. Oh, this one going to be 1 again. 1 squared. And we square that. And on the upside now we have minus 2 minus the 5 that we factor out on the inside and the 1. But I don't even have to put that 1 because I know that 1 squared is 1 and 1 is 1. Anything times 1 is 1. So And again, for demonstration purposes, I would put it still. But I mean, you like you work it out. So it's like, yeah. So our final answer here would be 5 into x plus 1 all squared minus 7. Minus 7. Minus 2 minus 5 is minus 7. I trust you got that as an answer. Let me just double check. Minus 2 minus 5. Yeah, that's minus 7. Da, 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 da. I divided by 5, I got 2, yep, everything checks out. Next one, again, let's pair our x's. So we pair our x terms. And after this, I want to eliminate. I want to get x squared to be 1. So I factor out 3. So that leaves me with x squared plus 4 thirds, because 3 cannot go perfectly into that. So 4 thirds squared. I like 4 third x plus 1. So that's that. Then I'm moving on. I'm finding half of b, and let me do that first so that you'll understand what I did. So that's half multiplied by 4 thirds. 2 could go into itself once, 2 could go into here twice. So the answer here would be 2 thirds. So half of 4 thirds is actually 2 thirds, believe it or not. So we'll end up with 3. Open bracket, we have x squared plus 4 thirds x plus 2 thirds all squared. That's on the inside. And on the outside, we have plus 1 minus 3 times 2 thirds all squared. Right? So simplifying now, we should end up with 3 into x plus whatever half of b was. Half of b was 2 thirds all squared. And let's see if we could work on the outside here. So that's 1 over 1 minus, we have 3 into 4 over 9. How did I get 4 over 9? 2 times 2 is 4, and 3 times 3 is 9. You square the 2, you square the 3, and we get that. And then we know that 3 could go into itself once, and 3 could go here 3 times, so 3 cancel each other. So that leaves us with 1 over 1 minus 4 over 3. And of course, I want the common denominator, so I could multiply 1 over 1 is the same thing as 3 over 3. That still gives us 1. Just multiply by 3 to get common denominators. And when we solve this, 3 minus that will give us negative 1 third. Believe it or not, that's our answer. Sweet. Gotta love math. So yes, that's how we factor out this one completing the square. You could pause it there, instigate it, investigate. Let me just make sure. Let me be comfortable that I did it right this time too. Ah, yeah, I should have done it right. Let's go. And then we have our last one. And here again, I pair my x terms. I factor out my x squared, so it will become 1. So that will leave me with 8x minus, I'll put it this way first, 6 over 8x, right? Minus 7. But here we could break down, we could use 2, right? So 2 could go into 6 3 times, and 2 could go into 4, sorry. 2 could go into 8 4 times. So yes, let's break it down one time. So that's 3 quarter. If we leave it as 6 eighths, we'll end up with some bigger numbers, and then and to break down later on might be a hassle. So yeah, so that's that. And once we do that, then we find half of b. So we have 8 into x squared minus 3 quarter x plus. And half of this, and by now I think you should get the pattern, half of that would be 3/8 over, I mean 3/8 all squared. A matter of fact, let me just say you get the pattern, eh? Let me show you still. So that is half multiplied by 3/4. That's how I got 3/8, right? So nothing here could break down, so you just multiply across and you end up with 3 over 8, which is half of 3/4, right? And on the outside, now I have minus 7 minus the 8 that I factored on the inside multiply by half of b. Oh no, look at this. This is negative. So this would be negative 3/8 all squared. Yes, negative. Because it's negative 2/3, negative 3/4. So yes, we have to be consistent with that. And grand finale, we have 8 into x minus whatever half of b was, 3/8. Negative 3/8, so negative. That's what determines this sign here. Negative 3/8 all squared minus. Okay, let me work on that other side function here first. So that's the same as 7 minus 7. Let me be specific there. So minus 7 over 1 minus, inside the bracket, we have 3 squared. So 3 squared will be 9. 8 squared will be 64. And the negative will get carried away somewhere where you do the squaring. When you multiply the negative by negative, you end up with positive. So this works out to be minus 7 over 1 minus 9 over 8. Good. 8 could go into itself once, and 8 could go into 64 8 times. So that leaves us with 9 8. And now I want here to have common denominator, so I could just multiply this side here by 8, top and bottom. So 8 7s, that's supposed to be 56, I hope. Yeah, it should be, man. I know my timetables. Divided by 8 minus 9 over 8. So the final answer, definitely it's a negative number still. So the final answer here seems to be what? 65? 65 over 8. Can this number break down any further? Yes, it could, but oh gosh, I cannot see my... Can I do this one without? Well, I could do it, but I feel lazy. 65 times 8. So I'm getting 8. Yeah, man, I should have seen that. So the final answer, if you want to change this into a mixed number, we're seeing 8 into x minus 3/8 all squared minus 8 and 1 over 8. That's how we could look at it. 8 8s are 64 plus 1 is 65. So yeah, this is our story here. So again, this is basically how we complete this square. And again, you would only get good and better at it by doing it over and over. So just keep practicing, do examples from the textbook, do examples from online, look at other YouTube videos and see if you get a different perspective how to solve it. For all I know, there are more interesting and maybe easier ways. I don't know if this way might seem complicated, but for all I know, there might be easier ways or easier steps to take. All right. I think the only challenging thing with this, to be honest, is when we're dealing with fractions. And that simply comes down to your perspective of fractions. If you like fractions, believe me, you don't even have a problem. You don't sweat it. Okay, it's just following the same procedure. Good. But we're going to bring it to the end there today and for this week. Next week, we're going to wrap up this series of factorization by looking at the quadratic formula. I think that's the last part, quadratic formula. And then we'll take it back down to geometry, where we had to wrap up on the circle. We had to find out the areas of circle, sector, segment, length. And we also had to find out volumes of some solids. So we're going to look at that after we finish the video on Monday. So until you take care, and until, enjoy your weekend.